read a review of the book. Many times I believe you have read the reviews of books. By the way, there are review websites as well nowadays. Has it ever happened to you that you want to go to a restaurant and before going or maybe you want to go visit a place and before going there you would like to go to internet and read reviews? Okay, yes. Let's see what other people have said about it. See, and there is a very famous food review website. Its name is Yelp, Y-E-L-P. It gives reviews about almost every restaurant. Food was good, service was good, ambience was good, all about that. So a review is like a way of learning from other people, what other people have done, what other people have gone through, and kind of getting from their experience, getting insights from their experience. So the review is fun to write. Let's talk about some things that one should actually remember before writing a review. Before you begin your writing of a review, the first question that you may have in your mind is, okay, what tense am I going to write? Am I going to write in past tense or present tense? Well, the answer is that if you are going to write a review of a movie or a drama, like a book that has already been released, then you would write in past tense. If it's a restaurant review, it's preferred that you write in present tense because it still exists, they're offering their services and like everything is going on. However, mostly you will find reviews of movies, dramas, books in past tense. However, for other things, you may find them in present tense. Another thing is how you prepare yourself for writing a review. A review is a kind of an article that requires research. Before you begin, it is your job to find out how much research is already done, what other people have written about it, because you are joining that conversation. See, if I have written a review, let's say on a movie, let's say any Christmas movie, can anyone tell me the name of any Christmas movie? There is a famous movie on Netflix. Its name is The Royal Prince. And it's a Christmas movie, it's a good movie. They have also released its different sequels. So let's say if I am going to write a review on that movie, and Aziz and Shaista have already written reviews on that movie, now I'm joining that conversation. So in research, it is important for me to know and to read what they have written so that I actually add to that conversation. Similarly, it is important for you to see how much material is already available. It is important for you to see how much time I have to write. Like, you don't want to get your review out by the time the movie is already old. See, technically there is no strict deadline as there is for editorial writing, as there is for column writing. There is no strict deadline, but still there has to be a timeline that you will have to follow. So two things I have said, that for review writing it is important for you to do your research. Number two, it is important for you to know about your timeline. And another thing is, show some ambition. I mean, your ambitiousness. You should be really, really interested in that thing, in that piece of artifact, in that restaurant or whatever place, I mean, you are going to write or your review. You should be ambitious to learn more about it. Now, with that, I would like to ask you a few questions. If I ask you, and each of you, if I ask you to write a review, what kind of topic you will choose? Would you like to write a review on a restaurant, on a place, on a book, on a movie, on a drama serial? What would be your choice? Let's begin from Aziz. If I ask you to write a review, what would you like to begin with?
I would probably choose a book I've written for.
Okay, you would like to write a review for a book. Very good. Shaista?
For a movie.
For a movie, yeah, me too. Aruj?
For a drama or a movie.
For a drama. Personally, I feel like I would love to write a review on a restaurant. That's something that, restaurants are kind of places where we usually go. And to me, writing a review of a restaurant is like getting some information out about that eatery. Shiza?
Ma'am, for movie and for cars.
For cars?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can find, I mean, if there is a new technology that just came out, people would write reviews on that, like how it is Where have you read them?
On websites?
Online.
Yes, on websites and what else? Like formal pieces of review. Not a review that you often find on website. Everyone is free to write a review for the website. But people who write reviews for newspaper, they are actually published pieces of articles. And that is based on formal writing. That is review that we are discussing here. Yes, Aziz?
It is a piece of opinion,
and for that reason they are published. Okay, you can find reviews in magazines. When I ask you to go over contents in TNS, the news on Sunday, did anyone find any book review there? They publish a section, its name is Literati. They usually
yes.
publish books.
Yes,
ma'am. In Literati, they publish book reviews. Have you ever read? Similarly, Dawn publishes a special edition, I think, every Thursday or Saturday, I have forgotten what day, but its name is Books and Authors, where they only publish reviews on upcoming books. Similarly, the New York Times also publishes reviews on upcoming new books. The New York Times also does that. All right, where else can you find book reviews? Scholarly journals, like the journals that you find on databases, on JSTOR, on EBSCOhost. So scholarly journals also publish book reviews. Let's see, if I am in the field of philosophy and there is a new book in philosophy and I want to find, okay, I buy my book, but I also want to find out what people are saying about this book. So where can I find book reviews? In scholarly journals. Scholarly journals also publish book reviews.
They also publish reviews of research articles.
Very good, yes. Research articles, no, it's not a frequent case, but usually you can find reviews
yes,
of books in scholarly
I've seen
journals.
That.
Yes, and other than that, magazines, special editions, they all contain. Have you ever read a food restaurant's review in Dawn? I have read reviews of restaurants in Dawn a lot. I have read reviews of many restaurants that are on MM Alam Road in Dawn. I have also read reviews of restaurants from Karachi, restaurants that are in Clifton area and all that, and restaurants on beaches. Many times I have read these kind of reviews in Dawn. It's a kind of common thing, you can easily find it there. For Wednesday, try to find a review for class activity before you come to the class. This is your homework. When you come for your class on Wednesday, please bring a copy of the review with you. Alright. Now, this document that you see on the board, it has some steps that tells you what are important considerations when you plan to write a review. See, a review must include a strong opinion about the subject. Is it okay to criticize the artifact or item that you are reviewing in a review?
Yes.
Many times you may have read, well, yes, in this particular movie, the plot is very good, the story is very good, but there are serious flaws in the script. Or you can say there are serious flaws in characterization or in camera work. It is totally okay to criticize, of course, you should have solid reason for that. Alright. Make sure that readers know whether or not the play is worth seeing. Play, movie, restaurant, whatever you are, book is worth seeing if the novel is worth reading in the first paragraph of your review. So, in very first paragraph, you can talk about your opinion. It means that whatever you are going to talk about, whatever you are going to write about, you should have a strong opinion on that. Second is, tell when the play was performed or when the novel was published and what the author is known for already. Discuss author's style. Let's talk about J.K. Rowling, who is the author of famous book, Harry Potter. And if she comes up with another book, of course you would talk about when the book came out, when her new book came out and what the author is known for. Like a little bit background. If the author is new, or if restaurant is new, or anything you are reviewing, it's new, talk about it. That is, it's a new venture. Give a basic overview of what genre the play or novel is and what it's about, but do not give away the ending. You don't want to give any spoiler to your readers. So if you talk about a movie and you talk about all the story and you talk about all the what is going to end, that is a spoiler. That is because people want to know themselves how it is going to end, what kind of story it has. But you can talk about genre. You can talk about whether this movie is sci-fi or if it's mystery or if the book is about history, philosophy, whatever it is. But again, do not talk about the ending because that would be a spoiler. I remember I read a review many years ago, soon after the movie Khuda Ke Liye was released. That was a very famous movie. And I read its review in Dawn. They talked about characters, they talked about this idea that Shoaib Mansoor has done his best. They talked about the idea that although these characters perform very well, however, we can see flaws in the acting of these actors. Like, that was a very strong review that I read. Similarly, you remember Shoaib Mansoor also worked on a song. Its title was Supreme Ishq, I think. It was based on an Arkali. It was an Arkali song. And I also read its review soon after the song was released. I read its review in Dawn. And the writer was of the view that, see, Anarkali is a kind of topic that many people have already worked on. We know. Bollywood made movies on the topic of Anarkali. Even Pakistani film industry also have done many productions on Anarkali. But Shoaib Mansoor, he kind of revived the idea. He thought about doing it all over again, and he did it in a very good way. And that is a very good presentation of that. That is a very good production. So I read a review on that as well. All right. Number four, talk about the characterization. I have already talked about this. I have already told you this. Are the characters well developed, authentic? Can readers relate to them? What would make them better? Like, if you keep all these points in view, it would be very easy to develop your writing. And by the way, I did not write all of this by myself. I found this on internet. When I was doing my own research on some techniques of writing reviews, this is what I found on internet. But I am sorry, I could not note the website address from where I got this. Students, today I am going to upload notes on Moodle that are related to review writing. And I'm also going to upload notes that are related to column writing as well. So it's better for you to read those notes for your exam preparation. Number five, talk about the plot. Is it original? Is it predictable? Is it intriguing? What is intriguing?
Interesting.
Very good. Interesting. Is it far-fetched or authentic? How does the story relate to geography? Now, you may see various movies that are not related to our culture, like Hollywood movies. It's difficult to find its application to our culture and everything. However, it's okay to talk about such things. Yes, this is a good production, but the setting that it discusses is related to Western culture or Western setup. Maybe it doesn't have its applicability to our culture. Compare and contrast the play or novel with other stories you have read, movies you have seen, or real life events. Let's talk about the review of a restaurant here. If there is a new Mexican restaurant in the area and you want to write about it, then you must have knowledge about what other Mexican food restaurants are there in the city, so that you can do some comparison and contrast. Okay, we have another Mexican restaurant in the city which is with this name, however this particular one which is new is better than the old one in this sense. Compare and contrast the novel with works by the same author and or other authors who write in the same genre. We're talking about children's books author J.K. Rowling. If you are writing a review on a new book,